15 laps of action already this season. And yesterday he eased away towards a comfortable victory. And I was talking to Sandy a little bit earlier on. He was saying he was surprised that he was able to jump into the lead at the first turn, having started from... Lights on. Lights out, away we go. It's a very good start from Jared Stern. Also, as they sprint towards comes the first time, it's Stern who takes the lead. It's side by side between Parlow and Stuvik. Down the hanger straight for the first time. And already Sandy Stuvik right underneath the rear wing of Jaren Stern. And Stern knows it. He covers the inside line into Stowe. Consults his mirrors. Stuvik looks to the outside. Stern has his Team Westech car perfectly positioned. There's no way through on that occasion for Sandy Stuvik. But again, Jaren Stern defends into the veil. Stuvik to the outside. It's Parlow. So it is Stuvik from Parlow. And Stern is now the white car of Alex Parlow. Stuvik out at the furthest extremity of the Silverstone Grand Prix circuit into Vale and Club, and then he picks up the pace, goes past the Formula 1 pit complex, the wing pit complex, along over the Formula 1 start and finish stripe and into the very, very fast Abbey curve. Really satisfying section of the circuit for the drivers as they go through Abbey, then to the quick left-hander at Farm. That will then propel them into the heavy braking zone for Village. Just snatching the brakes a little bit. Victory of the season, further extending his championship lead. It's through Abbey for the final time. Exits far for the second time this year. Is looking set to be a double winner in the Euro Formula Open. He won both races at Jerez. He's won at the Nürburgring and Portimao. And he is going to make it two from two this weekend at Silverstone in round five of the season. Sandy Stuvik takes the win, extends his championship lead. RP Motorsport celebrate as Alex Parlow comes through in second place. And Jaren Stern across the line in third for his fourth. 2.5 seconds in the end, his margin over Alex Parlow. And Jaren Stern, Konstantin Tereshchenko. From their cockpits. Sandy Stuvik looking to do much the same. It really has been a very impressive run of results from Stuvik. 6 victories in 10 races. He's only been on the podium once this year when he's not won, and that was a second place in the first race of the year at the Nürburgring. And that was a lovely fight as well between himself and Alex Parlow. Real maturity, because it was...
Interview, sixth win of the year. Must be you must be elated.
Yeah, I'm really, really happy about this. And Alex was on me the whole race. I think something happened to him in the last lap on Stowe, and that was the first time in the whole race that I could actually breathe a bit. So it was a really tough race, and yeah, I'm happy to be first again.
Yeah, as you say, not a relaxing race and not a very good start.
No, I had quite a bad start. Stern had a good one and then he got past, but I was able to outbreak him into Club, I believe. So. Yeah, it was a hard first lap, but I was happy to open a bit of a gap until I made a mistake in turn 5, and then Alex was on me the whole race after.
Good, but it went well, and now extending the lead in the championship.
Yeah, it's all gone to plan, so after the last weekend at Hungaroring, it wasn't so good, but I'm happy to regain some of the lead, and then now we'll have to see for the rest of the season.
Good, excellent. Well done.
Once more, Alex Parlow. Sandy Stuvik celebrating on the top step of the podium alongside RP Motorsport, who have won 8 of 10 races so far this season. Thailand in honour of Sandy Stuvik. He celebrates Silverstone of the presentation of the trophies then. Gary Wassell from Dunlop Motorsport presents Aaron Stern with the trophy for second. Peter Parlo with the runners-up trophy. Sandy Stubik, the winner's trophy. He's probably going to need a bigger shelf at home, given the collection of silverware that he's accumulated over the last three or so months. Same for RP Motorsport. They have really been the team to beat in these first five rounds of the season. They could well all change as we have the run-in at the end of the year. So with the photos and presentations complete, it's time to celebrate with champagne on the rostrum here at Silverstone, which means it's time for myself, Ben Evans, to say thank you very much for your company. I look forward to joining us at Spa in September.